Prince Harry has called for the Okavango River Basin to be protected from corporate oil drilling. In a joint opinion piece for The Washington Post, Harry and environmental activist Reinhold Mangandu described the Okavango River Basin in southern Africa as a natural beating heart that has nourished humans and wildlife for generations. But they warned of the imminent threat of corporate oil drilling, adding that it would pillage the ecosystem for potential profit. Harry and Mr. Mangandu wrote, "Some things in life are best left undisturbed to carry out their purpose as a natural benefit. This is one of them." The pair highlighted a huge oil spill off California earlier this month and a fire on the ocean's surface of the Gulf of Mexico in July after a gas leak from an underwater pipeline. Harry and Mr. Mangandu wrote, "There is no way to repair the damage from these kinds of mistakes. Drilling is an outdated gamble that reaps disastrous consequences for many, and incredible riches for a powerful few. It represents a continued investment in fossil fuels instead of renewable energies." In their joint article, the pair urged others to get behind the campaign. They said, "To protect the Okavango River Basin, we call on the world to stand in solidarity with us, our allies and local communities in advocating a full moratorium on oil and gas development in the region." Harry and Mr. Mangandu added, "Now, the choice is simple, either we honor our natural and life-sustaining ecosystems, preserving them for generations to come, or we exploit them on a path to permanent destruction. Will you stand with us?" Harry has regularly spoken out about the environment and climate change. However, Prince Harry branded fake eco-warrior as he jets off on private plane to play polo or for climate change hypocrisy. An NYC self-proclaimed eco-warrior Prince Harry when Meghan Markle a day full of celebrity photo shoots, "I traveled to New York City with a convoy of three SUVs that spewed gas." The awakened pair went to the One World Trade Center earlier this morning, took pictures with Governor Kathy Hochul and Mayor Bill de Blasio, and headed for the 9/11 memorial. From there, they pit-stopped at the luxurious Carlyle Hotel on Manhattan's Upper East Side. First-class suites cost an astonishing $8,800 per night. The couple stayed there for a four-day trip and were seen eating at a fashionable hotel restaurant after arriving at Big Apple from home on Wednesday night. California. Afternoon, they then United Nations at a 40-minute meeting with UN Ambassador Linda Thomas Greenfield on important discussions on COVID-19, racial justice and mental health. They will be performing at the Global Citizen Concert on Saturday at Central Park, which focuses on vaccine equity. It is currently unknown how they will spend the rest of Thursday and Friday. Luxury cars traveling around the city, including at least two Range Rover and one dark SUV, have CO2 emissions of 235 grams km per car. The couple would have traveled at least 20 miles in New York City. He has also launched a sustainable travel initiative called Travelist. However, he has been previously criticized over his use of private jets. Harry's call to protect the Okavango River Basin comes ahead of Prince William's Earthshot Prize Awards ceremony on Sunday. The Duke of Cambridge's £50 million initiative aims to find solutions to the planet's problems throughout the next decade. The winners in the five categories this year will each receive £1 million to develop their projects after being chosen by a judging panel. William and Kate are attending the star-studded awards ceremony, hosted by Clara Amfo and Dermot O'Leary, at Alexandra Palace in London. In an interview with BBC Newscast which aired today, William said, "The prize itself will stimulate solutions and action that a lot of people haven't necessarily produced yet, and so I'm hoping, you know, the prize will galvanize a lot of people in positions of responsibility to, you know, go further, bigger and actually start to deliver." Members of the royal family, including the Queen, Prince Charles, the Duchess of Cornwall and the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, are also set to attend the COP26 climate change talks in Glasgow, which start at the end of the month.